this down right there. Maybe 50 yards. Tagged out. Day 3. You can't beat that. Two bear came in. It was a smaller black bear. He's down right there. I'm bummed. Oh, thank you, Jesus. This has been awesome. I'm from Louisiana, and I don't know black bears very good, but I think this is a good one. He stood up. His back was almost even with that second rung on that barrel. And he came in, gave me a broadside shot. And I've always been told to shoot him middle of the middle, so that's what I tried to do. Going back, looked at my footage, and my focus was messed up on my camera, and it focused on a limb and not on the bear. So that's kind of frustrating. But it looked like I hit him, air zipped through, and I may be a touch low. I'm a little worried about that, but he ran about 40, 50 yards and stopped, and then I could hear some more brush break in a few minutes, maybe a minute after that. But I'm hunting up here with Simmons Sharks, David. I'm hunting up here with David Ology of Simmons Sharks. And he's killed quite a few bear, and he's always told me that when you shoot a bear, they run flat out until they die. And if that's the case, that bear's dead less than 50 yards away. Unless something squirrely happened and I missed, and all that hair threw me off. So anyway, I'm excited, but I'm also a little nervous. Because I'm not 100% positive. I was confident until I went back and looked at my footage, and now I don't know. So I can see my arrow stuck in the ground. I'm fixing to climb down and go check it out, and we'll see what we got. Well, I'm not very confident after I got down and looked at my arrow. I've never really bear hunted, so I don't know what this means, but my arrow has a good bit of fat and some blood on it. It's kind of watery. I know this bear was pretty fatty. I don't know whether that's just what big fat bear do with their long hair, and it tends to wipe the arrow clean, and there's not much blood on the arrow. I don't know. I'm a little upset right now. I'm anxious, but with me not being 100% sure of my shot and not hearing a death moan or anything, I walked in maybe 20 yards, not even that, and found a little bit of blood. And I just backed out. I don't want to push him if he is in there sick. I'm just going to wait till I get some help, and we'll track him after dark. And like I said, I've been told that when you shoot them, they run flat out until they die or get so sick they have to lay down. And he only ran flat out for about 40 yards, and then it just into a big thicket. And he stopped. And I could hear some brush breaking. He kind of side-heeled up. And when he stopped, there was a few second pause. And then I heard a little bit of brush breaking back maybe 15 yards down from where I heard him stop uphill. He went downhill. So hopefully that means he died and slid downhill. And that's what I heard. But like I said, after finding my arrow, looking at my arrow, I'm not I'm not as confident as I was up on the shot, so we'll just sit here till dark and wait for my ride. There's absolutely zero cell phone signal, so it's just a waiting game till dark now, and hopefully we'll be able to go in there and find a big bear, and I'll be tagged out. If not, I don't know, I'm gonna be pretty bummed, pretty upset with myself. So that's a unfortunate part of hunting. You don't really know. I mean, you do everything you can to make a good shot and to make it happen and make sure there's no any undue suffering on the animal, and you know, bad stuff happens, and I might be worrying for nothing. I might have just, you know, pinwheeled that bear, but like I said, I don't know enough about him to know whether the sign on my arrow is a good thing or his reaction was a good thing or what, but we'll find out shortly.
Well, I never really know what to say in these situations, but came in here last night and set the bait. Had two boar come in, one of the younger ones acting nervous, and this big fella came out, came up with the bait, got a shot off on him, and he tore out. I heard him run up side hill in just a little ways, and everything got quiet, and I heard a little brush breaking coming down the hill, but the shot felt good, but looking at my footage, it looked like I might have hit a little low, so we decided to back out till this morning and came in here, and it didn't take us no time to find the bear. He rolled down the side of the mountain here and fell in the bottom of the creek, and he is a dandy. He's a lot bigger bear than, there wasn't any ground streakage here, but shot him. I'm up here hunting with Dave Ology of Simmons Sharks, and I shot him with one of his tiger sharks, and like I said, the bear didn't go, I don't think he went 60 yards, and before he slid downhill, it definitely did a number on him, and I couldn't be happier. This is just it's been an awesome experience. Bear number two here in Idaho, tagged out, and good Lord bless me, and I appreciate everything that's happened for me, and like I said, I couldn't be happier. It's just been an awesome time. Beautiful bear. This is beautiful.
That's a good bear,
this
buddy.
This is going to be an awesome coat. Not coat, but rug.
That's a good bear, Harmon.
This ain't no teddy bear.
Praise the Lord, man. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He is a beautiful bear. Wow.
Bottom. I can do it perfect. But it's not flexed, Dad.